Welcome to day three of the competition of the 2017 World University Games in Almaty, Kazakhstan. It was a snowy day here in the city, but competition remained hot. Today, we'll see a women's hockey match between China and Kazakhstan. We'll see both men's and women's cross-country skiing, as well as the 1,500-meter speed skating event. And stay tuned to watch as the biathlon competition kicks off at the Universiad. Now, here is some curling action over at Almaty Arena. It was the host team Kazakhstan taking on the Canadians on these brand new sheets at this brand new arena. We've got highlights now of Kazakhstan taking on Team Canada. This round robin session also saw Korea win over the USA, Great Britain over Russia, Sweden, they took over the Czech Republic, and Japan took one over Norway. But it's Kazakhstan here who is about to take on Team Canada, who all come from the same university back in their country. That's Wilfrid Laurier University. Game now is about to begin. Kazakhstan will throw the first stone. A nice throw here, but Canada will have an answer, and they will answer in a big way. As this one slowly approaches that middle button, Canada will take 3 points on this first end. Up again here is Canada with a knockout shot, but Kazakhstan will have the opportunity now to try and knock some out themselves with some vigorous sweeping by the Kazakhstan team. It just won't be enough. Canada will take 2 more points in this end. At the end of three, Canada leads the way 5-0 over Kazakhstan. Again, they're up throwing the rock. Here's a slow one, barely making it to the 8 foot. Kazakhstan has the chance now to bring it back. They get a huge knockout here, eliminating 3 of Canada's stones, but one still remains there on the 4 foot. That's 1 more point for Canada. Now in the 5th end, you can see Canada's Aaron Squires throw a stone there. Fraser Reed and Spencer Newtall going to town, letting that one use the course on its own. It looks good from this angle. Gently glides right in there, and some more sweeping by Team Kazakhstan, eliminated over to the 12-foot ring. Now Team Kazakhstan is up, looking to get their name on the board. This one could do it for them. They get 1 point now. Canada leading the way just 6-1 over Team Kazakhstan. This will be the last end during this matchup. Here's Kazakhstan. That one lands right in the 4 foot. Now Team Canada, last end for them. They're gonna have the chance to knock that one back out. Able to get that last rock closest to the middle button there. They take that one 7-1 over Kazakhstan. You can really see the camaraderie here between these two teams, taking a quick picture after the game, and that will wrap up the first day of competition here at the 2017 Universiad. The highlights start today at Bulan Shulak Arena with women's ice hockey. The home team Kazakhstan taking to the ice as the fans fill up the bleachers. It would be a packed game here at the game in Almaty. Group A includes Kazakhstan, China, Great Britain, and Canada. Now, Kazakhstan will take on the People's Republic of China on home turf. The arena was packed with Kazakhstan fans, but China was represented there as well. This will be their second game here in Almaty. They lost their first one to Canada 9-1. They'll be looking to pick up their first win of the Universiade. This is Kazakhstan's second game as well. They won 11-0 over Great Britain earlier in the tournament and will look to continue their hot streak. Officials for the matchup, two Americans, one from Great Britain and one from Canada. Looking at the starting lineup here for the People's Republic of China. And for Kazakhstan, Daria Dmitrieva will start in net for the home team, while China's Ha Xia will begin as goalie for them. The Universiade's mascot, Sunkar, is in attendance at the arena as the women's ice hockey action gets ready to kick off. Team Kazakhstan pulls the early possession first in the game, but later when China goes on a two-player power play, the first goal will come from D Deng, a slap shot from the corner. Early in the second, China continued on the offense as Meng Yingzhang fires one in, getting right through the five hole of the goalie. Gonna take another look at that one in slow-mo. Slings it in there. The goalie has no time to react, and that's 2-0 now, China over Kazakhstan. Later in the second period, Kazakhstan gets in on the action. A power play goal by Malika Aldabergenova. The goalie for China, Ha Xia, gets her hand on it, but it just glides right over top. Now 2-1, China over Kazakhstan. Still in the second period, China was not done. A power play goal by Shi He from Xin Feng would bring them back up to 3 goals on the night. Take a look at this pass from Xin Feng. She finds Shi He wide open in front of the net, and she just bounces that one in there. Get that goal for China. That duo would be unstoppable here in the third. Xin Feng finds a wide open Shi He in front of the net. Gives her a little bit payback there, and that one is good for the last goal. China would take this one 4-1 over Kazakhstan. At the end of this game, both teams now move to a 1-1 record here at the Universiade. China will play Great Britain on February 1st. That's their next game. Kazakhstan will play on the same day as they take on Canada. It would be penalty minutes that made the biggest difference here in this game. Kazakhstan was in the box for 14 minutes as China got 2 power play goals in their 4-1 defeat over the home team. Now we'll move over to Alito Cross Country Skiing and Biathlon Complex, where the cross country women will compete in the 5-kilometer pursuit. It was a super snowy day on the mountain, but that didn't stop people from trekking up for the event. The start list was led by Russia's Lilia Vasileva, as well as 4 other Russian athletes, 2 Polish athletes, and 1 more from Kazakhstan. At the start, Vasileva would lead the way with a massive lead as the others started to follow. There she goes, taking a massive advantage of her huge lead here. Next up was Lilia Vasileva. She was quick to follow, as well as Anna Shevchenko. A couple others now straggling along, trying to catch up to those 3 who did have a massive advantage at the beginning of the race. At the first checkpoint here, at 1.2 kilometers, Russia's Vasileva led the way, followed closely by Nekavaskeva. Everyone else now making their way down the 5-kilometer race. Still, in the lead. The two Russians going head to head as they make their way down a small hill. At the next intermediate, the two Russians would switch places. Anna Nekovayaskeva makes her way into the first place position, again followed closely by Vasileva. Behind her is Kazakhstan's Anna Shevchenko, but she would fall behind now. Just the two Russians going head to head at the third checkpoint. Nekovayaskeva still in the lead. Here are some other countries competing now, trying to catch up to those two Russians who have taken a massive, massive lead in this 5K race. Nekovayaskeva coming up to the end of the race here. No one else in sight. She has really broken away here during that last push. As she continues to go full steam ahead, no one behind her. She's going to take the first place position in this race. Coming up from behind now, you can see Russia's Vasileva. She is going to come in second, following her other Russian counterpart. So the two Russians are going to take first and second. There's Anna Shevchenko with Kazakhstan trying to get that second position, but she will end in third place. Following that 5K race, athletes were absolutely exhausted, but happy with their performances altogether as they make their way off of the track. In the end, Russia claimed the 1, 2, 4, and 6 spot. Kazakhstan and Poland took 3 and 4. Nekovayaskeva, Vasileva, and Shevko received their bronze, silver, and gold medals following this event. The speed skating events has one of the most sought after venues here at the 2017 Winter Universiade. The outdoor rink at the Meduse Sports Complex sits in the bottom of the mountains here in Almaty. The first race here is between Japan's Nana Takashi and Kazakhstan's Yekaterina Aidova. Aidova will be on the outside ring, Takashi on the inside, and here they go, starting their race neck and neck. They take their first turn. You'll see them go right over their names here. You can't get confused of who they are on this one. At the 300 meter mark, still neck and neck, but Takashi, she leads the way by just 1 second. Now almost a minute in, Takashi still in the lead. Aidova was looking good. Takashi once again still in the lead. Aidova looking to catch up here as they start on their final stretch of the race. They take that final turn, and it's all a race from here. Takashi looking to catch up quickly. And she does it. She will take this race with a time of 2 minutes and 6.35 seconds. Take a quick replay here of that final turn where she gets that leg to go. The next race now is Korea versus Russia. Yeonjun will be on the inside track while Russia's Alexandra Kasherkina, she'll be on the outside track. There she is there. The two out of the gate quick, neck and neck once again. Thank you. At the 300-meter mark, Alexandra Kashurkina, she is on pace to win this entire race. Now, keep in mind, these two athletes aren't necessarily racing against each other. They are racing against that best time that we saw in the last race. At the next checkpoint, 700 meters, Kashurkina doing still quite well, just over a minute into the race. It's her last lap here now, 1,100 meters into the race, just over a minute and a half. Still, Kashurkina on pace to take the gold in this event if she continues with this speed. Here she is now in the final edge of this race. She will finish with a time of 2 minutes and 6.21 seconds, good enough for the gold medal. Korea's Yen Jen, she would finish in a time of 2 minutes and 9.28 seconds. Take a look at the board here. All three winners just milliseconds apart, but Kashurkina, Idova, and Takashi all received their bronze, gold, and silver medals respectively. Welcome now to the Alito Biathlon Stadium. It was a wet and snowy day in the foothills of the mountains, but that didn't stop spectators from coming out to watch the women's biathlon 15-kilometer individual event. It was only 0 degrees outside, but the wet snow made it cold for the athletes, like Galina Vishnevskaya and Australia's Sabrina Howell, who topped the start list to begin the race. Vishnikova from Kazakhstan, she's going to be the first one out of the gates. A few ones down the list, Rakova from Kazakhstan, she's going to go out fourth. She will end up winning first place eventually throughout this race. Approaching her first time taking shots now, here's Vishnevskaya. She will eventually miss just her last shot, moving on 4 for 5. Take a look at this here with that last bullet. Misses the last one. Now beside her, Rakova catches up beside her. Eventually, she goes absolutely perfect, 5 for 5 on her first. Both Kazakh athletes now get back onto the skiing course. After the first one, Rakova, she's in second. Vishnevskaya will stay in that first position as the other athletes start to get their shooting on. You can see them in the background there. The staggered start of this race makes it difficult to see who is in first, but you can tell now, here's Rakova. She's gonna take that first position soon enough. Vishnevskaya right ahead of her, but a very close race so far after the second shooting. Take a look now at Ukraine's Nadia Belkina. She's not placed right now, but she will end the race with the bronze medal, so we'll keep an eye on her as she gets back onto the track here. She got 2 penalties in that last shooting, but she'll make up for it in the end. Back over to Rakova. She's still going at it, chasing her Kazakh teammate Vishnevskaya. Again, Vishnevskaya, she's still in first, just 4 minutes right now over Rakova. At their third shooting event now, Rakova down on the ground. She will end this one with 1 penalty. There's Sunkar there cheering on all the athletes, but it would be Rakova's final shooting event that would seal the deal for her. Here she is now getting ready. She's gonna go 5 for 5, a perfect way to end the race. There you see it, a great finish for the Kazakh athlete, everyone cheering her on as she gets to the final race to the finish line. Here's Vishnevskaya, she's gonna finish with a time of 1 hour, 2 minutes, and 9.8 seconds. That will be good enough for the silver medal. Following closely behind, that's Kazakhstan's Rakova. She finishes under an hour, 59 minutes, 48.7 seconds. You can see she is just exhausted here. And in third, Ukraine's Bielkina. She will pick up the bronze medal. Rakova now, 2 years in a row, she is winning this gold medal in the women's 15-kilometer individual pursuit. Last but not least, the men's cross-country 10-kilometer pursuit got underway at Alito Cross-Country Skiing and Biathlon Complex. It was foggy up on the mountain with light snow and a temperature of just 0 Celsius. The athletes warmed themselves up and stayed active as they waited for the action to begin. Russia's Valery Gonter would top the start list, followed by another Russian athlete, Dmitry Rostovsev. You can see here, Rostovsev will start just 0.08 seconds after Gonter. There he goes there. You can see Gonter there out to a good head start before Rostovsev gets out, going onto the track, both of them now neck and neck, heading down the hill. Rostovsev gets ahead. He pulls ahead before everyone else gets their beginning here. You can see them breaking out of the tracks. Still, Rostovsev leads the way just by seconds as he turns this corner. At the first checkpoint here, 9.5 minutes into the race, Rostovsev, he leads the way. Gonter not far from him there. He will keep that lead here, but it's a close one between these two. There we go at the 5 kilometer mark, almost 13 minutes into the race. It is neck and neck between these two Russian athletes. There's Mika Yelyan. He will eventually end in third place, but he's got some catching up to do now as these two continue to be just seconds apart. Here's Gonter. Falling way behind now, Rostovsev, as he continues to push at the 7.6 kilometer mark, just under 22 and a half minutes here into the race. Rostovsev, he's going all the way. Still has quite a big lead here as we look at Mika Yelyan from Armenia. He will end, again, like I said, in third place. Rostovsev, a big lead here, followed by Gonter. Gonter making his way to try and catch up now as he comes to the finishing end of the race. Winning it all though, Rostovsev. He's gonna finish first for Russia. That's the first gold medal for him. Very happy with his race. You can tell he is once again just as tired. Gonter making his way in. Quite a big lead there. 14.7 seconds was between the first and the second athlete. And now Mika Yelyan with Armenia. He finishes and claims the third. Rostovsev, Gonter, and Yelyan all got their medals right after the event, gold, silver, and bronze.